Douglas had taken the midnight goods to the station on the other railway. He was just shunting, ready for his return journey, when he heard a faint tsss. That sounds like an engine, he thought. The hiss came again. This time it sounded almost despairing. Who's there? He asked. A whisper came. Are you Sir Topham Hatt's engine? I am proud of it. Thank goodness, I'm Oliver. We're escaping to your railway, but I've run out of coal and have no more steam. Is it from scrap you're escaping? Yes. I'd be glad to help you, but we mun work fast.
Both crews joined in. They took off Oliver's side rods and wrote out transit labels and chalked scrap everywhere they could. Douglas marshaled Oliver in front of his train.
No time to turn around. I'll run tender first.
Doot doot,
yelled a passing diesel. A steamer's escaping.
Doot doot.
Douglas puffed firmly on. Take no notice, he said, but they were stopped before they could clear the station.
The foreman's lamp shone on Oliver.
Aha, he said, a Western engine.
He shone his light further back.
A Western coach and a brake van, too? You can't take these.
Can we now? Said Douglas's driver. They're all for us. See for yourself.
Douglas's guard showed him the labels and papers. Oliver's crew, hiding in the coach, hardly dared to breathe.
Seems in order, said the foreman, but it's queer.
Sure it is, said the guard, but I can tell you queerer.
So could I, interrupted the foreman. Right away, guard.
That was a near thing, puffed Douglas with relief.
You've had worse, smiled Oliver. We ran at night. Friendly signalmen would pass us from box to box when there were no trains about. We got on well till Control heard about a mystery train and tried to hunt us down.
What did you do?
A signalman let us hide on an old quarry branch. Driver, fireman, and guard blocked the cutting with rubbish and levered one of the approach rails away. We stayed there for days with diesels baying and growling like hounds outside. I was very frightened then.
Small blame to you, said Douglas feelingly.
Presently they rumbled over the bridge and onto Sir Topham Hatt's railway.
We're home! He can't catch us now!
Tell Isabel and Toad, please.
Douglas called out the news and heard a cheerful ding-a-ling-ling.
He was surprised.
Oliver chuckled.
That's Isabel. She has a bell, you see. She's very clever.
When we go out together, I pull one way and push the other. When I pull, I can see ahead, and when I push, I can't. So Isabel does a good lookout and rings her bell to talk to me.
You dinna say.
Douglas was impressed.
This Toad, he continued, is he?
Hold your wish, hussed the driver. Yon's the works. We won't sleep unbeknownst and find a place for Oliver.
Douglas tried hard to be quiet, but the foreman heard and had to be told their secret.
I know the place,
he said, and showed them a siding nicely hidden away. Oliver said goodbye and thank you, and Douglas puffed away.
Yon's an enterprising engine, he thought. I wanna wait here with Donald, but I be feared to do it on my own.